The trial is about the medical treatment of patients who underwent bypass surgery. Every year, about 400,000 people undergo coronary artery bypass grafting. And a big question is, what is the optimal antiplatelet therapy for these patients? We know that a major issue in these patients is graft patency, and that can be influenced by optimal antiplatelet therapy. The mainstay of this therapy is aspirin, so all these patients receive aspirin as early as possible after bypass surgery, but the question is whether there may be better alternatives. For example, we have learned that aspirin is not as well metabolized in patients who just underwent major surgery. Therefore, the question was whether ticagrelor, another antiplatelet agent, is better than aspirin in these patients. So in this trial, we wanted to include 3,850 patients in 26 centers, but after a data safety monitoring board review, after we had been halfway into the study, so after 1,850 patients that were randomized to aspirin or ticagrelor, we got the order to stop the trial for futility. It was a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled international studies involving 26 centers, and all patients underwent bypass surgery and were treated with the study medication for 1 year. Yeah, we completed the trial. The follow-up was 1 year, so all of these 1,850 patients went through complete follow-up. And the event rate ended up to be somewhat lower than expected. We were expecting an event rate of cardiovascular death, myocardial infarction, stroke, or repeat revascularization of about 13%, but it ended up to be in the aspirin arm at 8.2%. So quite a bit lower than other trials before had shown. And in the ticagrelor arm, the event rate was 9.7%. So numerically, it was higher in the study medication rather than aspirin. And therefore, the Data Safety Monitoring Board said that there is no way that this is going to be a positive trial, even if we double the number of patients, and recommended to stop recruitment prematurely. Yeah, a major concern in these patients undergoing bypass surgery is bleeding. Obviously we monitored blood loss and bleeding events in these patients very carefully. And one important conclusion was that the rate of major bleeding was similar in the aspirin and the ticagrelor arm. So if, for example, a patient cannot take aspirin for some reason, we can take these data also that ticagrelor is safe and is about as effective as aspirin after bypass surgery.